In this video, I'll be showing you how to set up an InDesign document for creating a brochure. So with InDesign open, head over to New File, and a tab like this will open. Head over to Print at the top. As I'm creating an A5 brochure, I'm going to use the A5 preset. If your preset isn't visible here, you can always type it on the right. So let's begin with pages. Stapled brochures only allow for pages with a multiple of 4, and perfect bound brochures only allow for multiples of 2. However, when making a perfect bound, you'll need quite a bit of pages so that you're able to have a spine. If you have a little amount of pages, I recommend going with a stapled brochure. In this case, I'm making a 12 page stapled brochure, so I'm just going to put 12 pages here. And then facing pages are a 2-page spread, your left and your right page. It just means that when closed, like, the pages will be facing each other. So yeah, and you'll most likely have this ticked when you're working on a brochure, as it's such a common thing. Columns are a very useful feature, as they help arrange text, content and copy. It gives it an effective look, as well as managing them into a given space. So I'm going to go for 2 columns and a gutter space of 5mm. The gutter is the space between each column. I'll go more in depth about columns later on in this series. Right, next up, margins. Margins are the distance from the edge of the page to the content. Margins help you keep a layout, making a design more digestible and cohesive. I'd recommend a 10 to 20 millimeter margin when working on a brochure, depending on the info. Maybe if there's a lot more info and copy, maybe smaller margins. But again, that's down to personal preference, really. Finally, we have bleed. Bleed is used for most print documents, as this is where your artwork will be trimmed once printed. So you need to avoid putting any important info within the bleed area. The common bleed size is 3mm. So this will be a 3mm guide on the edge of your page. So now let's go ahead and create the document, now that we've set up all the details correctly. So as you can see, we've got the document opened here, and if I zoom out, you can see all the pages we've made. So we have the front cover and then all the facing pages, number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And then the back cover, 12, which is a single page. So now let me just run you through the meaning of each guide here. So the red line with the grey space to the edge of the page, this is known as the bleed. So as I said earlier, you don't want anything with any important info within that area. This outer border here on the page is known as the margins. And these two rectangles are known as the columns, with this space in between known as the gutter. So the first step is creating my cover. Luckily though, I've created a cover earlier, and here it is. This is a replication of the Wolves cover, which I thought stood out from the bunch. I think it had such a lively feel to it. I think the grunge, the idea of a splattered ground, the lighting on the player, the shadows, it just all helped bring this design alive. So here's a before of my one, and this is the after once edited. If you want to know how to cut out plays or a subject from a background, or create a layer mask, we all have that on our YouTube channel. We have tutorials, which you can find on our YouTube channel here. And here is the Wolves one, which I've replicated. So yeah, this is the cover I've made. So let me show you how to import that into InDesign. So now if I head over to InDesign, and I head up to File, and I go down to Place, and I select my program cover, and I just click with it placed. And then if I head to my align area, and I align to page, and align it to page, and right now it looks a bit rough like this. This is because if I go to view, my display performance is set to typical display, meaning that it's trying to prioritize the speed my InDesign runs. However, if I put it on high quality, it may slow down your computer, but you can view it at a higher quality. And as you can see, everything fits within the margins here. Some parts obviously going out slightly, but that doesn't matter too much. Like here, it's not a massive deal. Unfortunately, I don't think you would be able to achieve this design in InDesign, so I had to go and make it on Photoshop. But having a PSD is quite handy, because if I go and edit the name, for example, on my PSD, let's make it larger and centralize it. And now if I save it out, if I go back to InDesign, as you can see, it hasn't updated yet, but I've got a little warning icon appearing up here. Just head to your links on and then double click that warning sign, and it updates your template. The text isn't aligned there, obviously. I could have done a better job, but hope that makes sense. Thanks for watching this episode. I hope I helped when it comes to setting up a InDesign document. Stay tuned, because in the next episode, we'll be going over the Brighton program. Thank you.